Estamos con otro de los grandes a la ofensiva para el equipo de Metros y héroes en la victoria, tercera de manera consecutiva, Julian Mills. Julian, you get the third win in a row. What was the key tonight?
We got some stops down the stretch and just moving the ball. And I mean, they made some tough shots the whole game, and the main thing was just to keep playing defense and contesting their outside shots. So I feel that kind of turned the game, but I mean, they played a great game as well.
Le preguntamos a Julian que cuál fue la clave para la victoria de hoy, de tercera de manera consecutiva. Él dice que lo importante fue que pudieron parar en momentos importantes al equipo de Reales de la Vega, que tuvo un gran partido, pero que finalmente en la segunda mitad ellos pudieron ajustar en la defensa y que eso les valió para la victoria.
You step up in the fourth quarter, score 9 points. Points important for the win.
I mean, that's what they brought me here to do. So, I mean, I just was trying to, play my role. I was kind of down on how I played last game. So I just wanted to come out and just, do what I needed. So, I was passing the ball well in the first half. And then in the second or in the fourth quarter, my shots were there. I took them and I made them. So I don't want to take full credit for the win because we played a great team game. It just happened to be my teammates found me and I was able to make the shots and get us the win, which was huge. So I'm happy for that.
Decíamos que él tuvo un buen cuarto periodo que le valió a Metros esos puntos para lograr la victoria. Dice Julian que él no quiere llevarse el crédito por eso. Sus compañeros pudieron encontrarlo abierto, pero que él se alegra mucho, obviamente, de que esos tiros cayeran y que los Metros lograran la victoria.
Finally, Julian, on Sunday you have a tough match against Indians. What are you going to do to get the win there?
Well, obviously, Robert Glenn gave us 41 points, so, I mean, that's going to be a key factor in trying to curb some of his points, but we know that they have other players that can step up as well, so we're just going to have to keep, playing team basketball and focusing really on us, and, whatever the coach game plan is, we just got to try to go out there and execute it and then see what happens, so we know it's going to be a tough battle.
Deseamos que el domingo tiene un importante encuentro ante Indios de San Francisco de Macorís. Él dice que sí, que lo principal es para Robert Glenn, que no tenga un partido de 41 puntos otra vez, y que si ellos siguen ejecutando de la manera que lo han hecho en estos últimos encuentros, el equipo de Metros, además de que Indios tiene otros jugadores también que pueden elevar su nivel, cree Julian que van a estar bien. Julian, finally send a message to Metros fans.
Just that we're playing hard to try to win the championship, and it's going to be a long road. There's going to be some ups and downs, a roller coaster. So you just have to stick with us in the hard times and the bad times. So today looked a little bit down, and we were able to pull it out. But it's just that's what it is. It's a basketball game. It's a game of runs, and it's going to be wins and losses. But right now we're just working towards putting more wins. So we got 3, and we're trying to get to the fourth one.
Julian, thank you and good luck.
All right, thanks. Appreciate it.
Ahí estaba Julian Mills. Finalmente dice él que a los Metros, a los fanáticos de los Metros, que vengan a apoyar al equipo, que habrá momentos malos, habrá momentos buenos, pero que los fanáticos deben mantenerse con el equipo y que en esta temporada, que es bastante larga, él espera que los fanáticos sigan apoyando al equipo y eso le va a dar un soporte mucho mayor para lograr más victorias. Para lo que pasó hoy, Víctor Martí. Estamos con el